pregame show.
Early season's greetings, NBA fans. I'm Ernie Johnson. Thanks for joining us. Got Shaquille O'Neal here. Got Kenny the Jet Smith here for this edition of the NBA on 2K Sports. We'll watch the Miami Heat in this one as they go up against the Houston Rockets. Taking a look at the Rockets, a win tonight would bring them to 3-0 on the young season. What a start that would be for them. They've looked awfully good in those first two wins. And here in the early going, some teams already fulfilling their potential while others struggling out of the gate. Shaq, how big a deal are these initial outcomes?
Ernie, let me tell you something. I hated losing, period. Didn't matter if it was early, late, whatever. I expected to win every time out.
Well, the reality is of it, you have 82 games. So if you get too high or too low in your little valleys or your peaks, you're going to be in big trouble. But every loss and every win does affect home court advantage if you're a veteran team trying to make the playoffs and trying to win it all. So you're thinking about every loss. If you lose in April, it hurts just as much when you lose in January.
And time now for tip-off. Let's send it to Kevin Harlan. He's got the call.
Coverage of the NBA here on 2K Sports. A happy Sunday evening to you and yours. This is Kevin Harlan alongside Clark Kellogg and Greg Anthony with Doris Burke on our sideline. They're just off a road trip and the Heat are looking to settle back in here at home. And this is the first season matchup for them against this Rockets team. They lost both of the matchups in this interconference battle a season ago. They'd like to change that now.
And this is the first of two games between the two, East versus West, so they don't see a whole lot of one another.
Yeah, and Greg, for me, that just raises the intrigue level. Some matchups we don't get to see that often, so I'll be watching this one closely.
The Rockets win the tip. And the Houston Rockets starting five. Mota Yunus and Howard the post pair. Harden and Ariza filling out the perimeter. And it's Lawson in at the one. And here we go. Wade heading to the hoop. Finished off the break. Wade's got his team on the board to start the game for the Heat.
And they get the first bucket.
And they'll hope that sets the tone at the offensive end going forward. It doesn't always work out that way, but better to start fast than not.
Now here's Mota Yunus. Against Golden State, he was really on his game. Six to shoot. Harden against Wade. And they'll turn it over. Could not get off a shot. 24-second violation. Rockets on defense. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
And how about the game plan that was constructed for that one? I mean, it was apparent how powerless the D was to stop it.
Yeah, that's a good way to put it. I mean, they just didn't have an answer for anything they threw at them. Just some amazing stats put up by Chris Bosh early in his career. But having been in the shadow of LeBron and D-Wade over the past few seasons, one wonders if Bosh is now a little bit underrated. He's talented and gives you everything you want from the power forward spot.
Earlier, Doris Burke spoke with head coach Eric Spoelstra. And what'd you find out, Doris?
He said that they'd be focusing a lot of their defensive energies on containing Ty Lawson, especially in transition. He added, Lawson is one of the fastest players in the league. So if you let him get out and run, you're putting yourself at a huge disadvantage. We've got to keep him in the half court and limit his penetration. Guys?
All right, Doris, thanks. And it's Wade in the corner. A three ball. The rebound by Harden. On defense, the Heat. Tough loss coming against Cleveland in their last game played.
Yeah, major problems at the charity stripe in that game. They just could not convert their free throws.
And that makes it hard to win, especially on the road. You get a chorus of about 20,000 yelling at you every time you put one off the rim. Boy, that's got to wear on you.
Here's Wade. Ty Lawson making his last shot. Dang with the bucket. Here in the first, just under 2.5 minutes played so far. Lawson dishes to Howard. Harden kicks to Howard and stolen by Whiteside. And here's Dragic. He's coming off a 19-point game against Cleveland. Whiteside sets the pick for Wade. Here's Bosch. The shot, no good. Good D by Ariza. For Houston, they've gone 2-3 here to start out the game. Screen by Howard. Harden with it. And Bosch picks him up defensively. Harden the pass to Ariza. Monty and his kicks to Lawson. Shot clock at 5. And the foul called on Hassan Whiteside. That is his first foul of the game.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
Harden outside. 6 on the shot clock. And it's Wade with the rebound.
You rarely see him missing dunks, but the defender was right in his face on that one, and it threw him off just enough.
Bosch, a screen on Harden. Harden against Wade, and there's a whistle. That's going to go on James Harden. That is his first foul of the game. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into the first quarter, and there's the call on Howard. That's his first foul. Wade on the wing, guarded by Harden. Right side a screen, shot clock at 6. It's Dragic with the drive, and it's wide right, hits off the rim.
Yeah, good tough D there to get a hand up and force that miss.
That's example number one of why he is such a strong defensive player and why he has such a great defensive reputation.
Now, here is Harden. Guys, James Harden, quite possibly the most devastating rim attacker in the league today, just refuses to slow down. Wayne Clark, he's going right at the basket.
Yeah, he's got it all, Kevin. I mean, he's so thick and strong and has deceptive moves and explosiveness. When he gets inside, he's scoring or you're fouling.
This is his first trip to the line tonight. The first free throw is good. Both good from the line that time.
And that's the norm for him. He's pretty much automatic when he's at the line.
The dish to Whiteside. Wade against Harden, and it's Wade penetrating. Dang gets a wide open look. Miami no good on that time either.
When you're defending Harden, it really is a pick-your-poison situation. I mean, we talked about his driving, but you can't gap him because he's also a very good shooter and passer. So that double team that you want to provide as well, he's real good at finding that open man.
Again, the miss by Harden. Miami's gone 0-2 from deep here. Wade dishes to Dragic. Pass to Bosch. 16 feet away. And it's good off the back rim and in.
And guys, another thing about Harden, he draws so much attention defensively. So even when he misses around the rim, oftentimes it's going to create offensive rebound opportunities for the Rockets. So he takes the whole defense with him.
Here is Harden following the basket by Chris Bosch. Ariza, the dive for the ball. And it's out of bounds. Last touch by Ariza. Now that we have a chance, let's go to the 2K leaderboard and reveal last season's top shot blockers. Second is Hassan Whiteside.
You know, he was a consistent shot blocker because he got his hands on shots that looked like they were free and clear, and then boom, he'd come out of nowhere and deny it.
The Heat with the lead. Outside Dragic. Passes it to Bosch. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Knocked loose. Hit stolen by Ariza. And here comes Lawson leading the fast break. Harden's shot is off. The Heat have gone 4 for 9 from the field to start this game off. Rogic kicks to Wade. Double team by Wade. Right side Bosch. It's stolen by Ariza. To the left side wing. Lawson with it. Now guarded by Dragic. Mantiunas passes to Howard. Mantiunas dishes to Howard. And Lawson, here we go. And that one's good. Lawson's got his second bucket of the night. You know, Clark, the one thing you can say about Ty Lawson is his awareness around the floor. He's just ubiquitous, and his court vision is incredible.
Excellent peripheral vision. He averaged almost 10 assists a game last season. That's the best year of his career thus far.
Stoudemire's checked in for the Heat. Gerald Green comes in for Dwayne Wade. And a switch here also for Houston. Terrence Jones has checked in for Mantiunas. And Miami shooting 44% overall here in the first quarter. Green against Harden. Stoudemire with a screen on Harden. And Stoudemire, the bucket on the assist by Green.
You know, they've scored several times already here in the first quarter down low. I like that.
It's like a running game in football. When you can pound the basketball inside, it also allows you to control the team's transition.
The shot is off, and it's Houston the other way. Lawson outside. Back to Ariza. Feeds it to Lawson. Jones in the post, working on Bosch. And it's Terrence Jones with the finish.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
Dragic against Lawson. Here's Deng. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Deng's got his second basket.
Nice pass there to set that bucket up.
And that's 10 of their last 12 points that have come off assists.
Harden outside. It's Ariza on the wing. And he makes good on the layup. Ariza's got his first points of the game.
Oh, how about the floater there? Nice drop.
Rogic kicks to Green. And there's a whistle. That goes on Terrence Jones. That's his first foul. And Miami making a change here. Winslow's checked in. Houston with a big group substitution here. Capella's checked in. Brewer comes in for Trevor Ariza. McDaniels, he's checked in for James Harden. And it's Patrick Beverley in for Ty Lawson. Brewer with the steal. Oh, and a fast break for the Rockets. Brewer.
And I like how he puts himself in position there to finish on the break.
Yeah, you know, that's what we call seeing and feeling the game. Excellent read of how that play was going to develop and where the ball was going. That's stuff that you oftentimes can't teach, Greg.
And that was Kia bringing you the close-up on the big-time play. No good from Dragic.
And listen, sometimes even the best of us are going to miss the easiest of opportunities.
Beverly dishes to Brewer. Here's McDaniels. It's stolen by Green. The kick out to Dragic. Stoudemire outside. And the wide open shot from Green. From outside, off the mark.
Rebounding is going to be the focal point for them in this one, fellas. I can feel it.
No, it always is, and it has been so far, and they've gotten a nice edge on the glass.
Now here's Jones. He's coming off a 10-point game against Golden State. Score of the basket, his second of two attempts.
I don't know what's happening defensively, but they're not putting up any resistance.
I tell you what, it reminds me of one of my college coaches. He used to say, "That ain't gonna get it done. That's 5 straight baskets in the paint now."
And it's good. Fought through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line.
Shaked and baked with the crossover move, and that's what freed him for the score.
And got him on the wrong foot and then just blew by him.
And Miami making a change here. Anderson's checked in. And for Gerald Green, another productive year last season coming off the bench. Though it was a smaller role, a small step back from the season before when he started over half the games for the Suns.
Well, there was a log jam in Phoenix at the wing position last season. He certainly matured, though, as he never complained about not starting, just went out and did his job.
Now here's Dragic. Stoudemire, the screen. Outside, Green. Five on the clock, and it's blocked. 1:52 left in the first quarter of the game. Jones with it. Now guarded by Dragic. Beverly, the pass to McDaniels. He dishes it to Brewer. Shot clock at five. Here's Capella. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
For Gerald Green, it's hard to not think about the star that could have been, the 18th pick in the 2005 draft, right out of high school. It was basically athleticism and upside in his game then. He's finally made it in the NBA now, but has improved with skills and guile in place of explosiveness.
Harrell, he's checked in for Terrence Jones.
And talking about Gerald Green, it seems like he's been in the league forever. But he was only 29 years old last season. By and large, he's avoided major injury, so he's still got plenty of tread left on those tires if he wants to keep going at it for a little while longer.
There's the lob to the hoop. It's stolen by Dragic. And, oh, here we go with Green. Nobody back.
Clearly a foul.
Yeah, he took a shot there. Earned those free throws.
And a moment to look at the scoring approach in terms of where the points are coming from for Houston.
Well, I like the fact they've already been getting a lot of high-quality shots in the paint.
And also, how about the willingness to attack the basket and challenge the defense here tonight? And guys, Gerald Green looked to be out of the NBA at one point in his career, but since coming back from Russia, he has completely reinvented himself as a player.
Here's Capella. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
That's the 10th straight point they've given up in the paint.
And you know, it doesn't matter how good your defense is on the perimeter if you're going to allow easy ones inside like that.
Now here's Dragic. 40 seconds left in the first quarter. They set the screen. And it's Green missing. And for Gerald Green, and him reinventing himself, really was just known as a dunker before heading overseas.
You know, Kevin, he came back with a better shot and a better understanding of how to win as a player. Strange to think that there was a time that he couldn't find a way onto an NBA roster.
Now, here's Brewer, looking for his first basket still in this one. The offensive rebound, and he gets it to go. And the Rockets lead by five.
Just lazy defense on the glass there.
Well, nobody boxed out. Nobody put a body on anybody else. Things like that not only drive the coach crazy, that stuff gets under my skin.
A good close contest so far as we finish the first quarter. Rockets lead by two. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side of this break. Now let's hear from Ty Lawson talking about the balanced attack of this Denver Nugget team.
We do have a team type of game. You know, everybody is scoring spread out, rebounding, everything spread out. So, you know, even from the bench, you know, it's definitely a team type game.
Well, that was the game plan a couple years ago when Denver was good enough to make the playoffs and Ty Lawson was at the control.
You know, but not enough firepower to be able to sustain with the elite teams, say like the Warriors or the Rockets. Ty Lawson, a solid, dependable player in our league, but this is still a league where you need your superstars to win rings.
Neither team able to build much of a lead up to this point as we start the second quarter. And looking at what we've seen from Houston, what do you guys think?
You know what? They're dominating on the backboard. They have controlled the paint thus far.
flexing their muscles down low, and they've limited second chances too, guys.
Taking a look at the Rockets, Harden and Ariza filling out the perimeter. Harrell is out there with Howard, and it's Lawson in at the point guard position. Now, here is Lawson. He picked up 12 points in their last win against Golden State. Just 5 on the clock. Shoots from 14. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls. Lawson's got 6 points.
I mean, even he was surprised to be that open.
Rogic against Lawson. Rogic kicks to Wade. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist. Wade's got his second basket of the game.
He's got so much junk in his trunk, he'll find a way to hurt you.
It's Harden with the drive. Over to the wing. Lawson dishes to Harden. Elbow shot. Hits the front of the rim and out.
That's one he knows he should have drained.
Dragic with it. Now Lawson defending. Dragic, the pass to Whiteside. And it's Miami with another.
And that's another assist for a team that is putting on a clinic on how to share the ball.
And I love the mentality that they've had. If a shot isn't there, they're not forcing it. They're moving it side to side until they finally get the one they want.
Here's Ariza. Hassan Whiteside made his last basket. Harden outside. Lays it up and banks it in. Harden's got 6.
They're finding lanes to the hoop now with consistency. 5 buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, Greg, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior. They've got to offer more resistance here.
And there's a whistle that's going to go on James Harden. That's foul number 2 for him.
And you can see he just didn't get squared up with his feet.
Greg, those are always tough to judge, but I think the official got that one right.
Chris Bosh is checked in for Miami. Monty Unis is checked in for Houston. Rogic kicks to Bosh. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist. Dragic has got 6 assists here tonight.
Well, I think it's been said about 1,000 times now how Coach Spoelstra started as a video coordinator with the Heat, but he's been with the organization for so long, they are starting to become synonymous.
Monty Unis, a strong finish under heavy pressure all over.
And gotta like what they've been doing down low in the post.
I certainly do. You know, I like to see guys do their work inside. Their rebounding has been excellent, and that's always important in a close game.
And that assist got him a little nod from his teammate after that one.
Greg, as you said, Spoelstra has been with the Heat for so long now in his 8th season. He was handpicked by Pat Riley to lead the team, and Riley Clark kind of molded him in his image.
Yeah, and it was clear that Pat Riley believes in him and continues to believe in him. Coach Spoelstra has had very high expectations on his shoulders ever since taking over the team, and he's actually lived up to them.
Here's Dragic, following the basket by Dwight Howard. Outside Dragic. Wade, right side. And that one comes up a bit short.
You're not going to see that very often. Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
Ariza has the open look. And unable there to get the go-ahead bucket. Heat have gone 5 of 6 so far from the field in the second quarter. Wade dishes to Dragic. Pass to Bosh. Ariza with the rebound. Rockets have gone 4 of 7 from the field in this second quarter so far. Harden kicks to Ariza. Harden the pass to Monta Unis. Kicks it out to Ariza. Stolen by Bosh. Lawson against Dragic. Stolen by Harden. And it's Houston on the break. Here's Monta Unis. Can't get it to go. Excellent D from Wade. The Heat with the lead. Dragic kicks to Bosh. Tipped away.
You know, they don't score on that shot, but they're going to be happy with those kinds of possessions.
And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two. And for Trevor Ariza, almost exclusively a perimeter player on the offense last year. New scheme, Greg, new teammates, big adjustments.
Yeah, the Rockets having Dwight Howard camping out in the lane and James Harden needing space for dribble drives. Not much room to operate inside for Ariza.
But they do like his defense, and we know he can hit the three. It's a pretty valuable commodity for him. Mm-hmm. Catching up on the changes for Houston. Terrence Jones has checked in for Howard. And it's Terry in for Ty Lawson.
You know, you talk about Trevor Ariza last season. I mean, his field goal percentage dipped to 40, mostly because he only took threes, or so it appeared. It's hard to be efficient if you're only shooting threes.
The Rockets making a switch here. Decker's checked in. Outside Dragic. The feed now to Whiteside. It's stolen by Jones. From downtown, Decker can't hit.
You guys, when you think about Trevor Ariza, he was signed by Houston last year to play defense. And did he deliver on that end? He was usually matched up against the opponent's best wing scorer, and he had the highest steals average of his career, almost two a game. Add to that, he is a knockdown shooter from beyond the arc.
Dragic kicks to Whiteside. Wade against Harden. Wade dishes to Whiteside. There's Dragic with the three. And again, it's the Heat missing. Rockets leading by three. Now, here is Harden. 6 points for him. It's stolen by Wade. Oh, and a fast break for the Heat. Stolen by Harden. Here's Monte Yunus. Good. It's Harden with the assist that time. And it's a 5-point Rocket lead.
Every time they get scored on during this run, it's come from inside the paint.
Yeah, they have really owned the interior. You've got to collapse that defense and force them to beat you over the top.
Well, a scary moment for Chris Bosh last year. He had to be shut down, Greg, as we all know, for the season after a blood clot was found in his lung.
You know, and Kevin, it really puts basketball in perspective. I mean, it happened right after the trade deadline, and obviously a huge blow to the Heat in terms of their push for the postseason. But fortunately, it looks like he's going to make a full recovery and have a huge impact this season.
Catching up on the changes with Miami. Amari Stoudemire is checked in for Whiteside. And it's Green in for Luol Deng. And a change for the Rockets. Corey Brewer's checked in for James Harden. Decker can't hit.
You know, the Heat never really came back after losing Bosh. His presence on both ends of the floor is hard to replace, and they missed him a bunch.
Now here's Stoudemire. The offensive rebound. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot. He'll go to the line.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth on that foul, stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
And, guys, I know I speak for everybody. Glad to see Chris Bosh back out on the floor. I mean, blood clots can be a very scary thing for anyone. And I think everyone is happy he's been able to make a full recovery.
And the Rockets making a change here. Capella's checked in. Shot is off. Bosh with some nice D. The Heat trail by three. Wade with it. His last outing, we saw him pour in 22. Off the pick. Again, the miss by the Heat.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
Terry with it. Now Green defending. Here's Brewer. The nine-footer's on the mark. Brewer's got his first basket of the night.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
And it's not just their passing, but also the body movement off the ball that's created a lot of those opportunities.
But Miami no good on that time either.
Not really his best quarter as far as scoring. Let's see if he can eventually get back on track.
D. Decker passes to Capella. Terry against Dragic. Lock at six. And it's Terry off the drive. One up, one down. 2 points with his first shot this game.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle much more effectively.
You just cannot allow the offense to have that quality of a look each and every possession.
No good from Dragic. Rockets leading by seven. Kicks it to Brewer. Here's Capella. Inside. Here's Jones. Good work defensively by Stoudemire. Miami's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. It's Dragic with the drive from 12 feet out. And Stoudemire with the basket on the assist by Dragic.
Just no chance for the smaller defender to block that shot.
He's really, really good at using his size to free himself up for those mid-range jumpers. A master at it.
Puts it up from seven, and it's blocked. Now Terry. There's Decker, and he uses both hands to jam it in.
Taking it to the rack with power right there.
And hammering down with the two-handed slam.
Just piling on the lead with a dunk like that.
The Heat trail by seven. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've had a number of empty ones, a long time without a basket.
They got to find something, you're right. Dragic with another miss.
Not able to find it here in the second. He's off stride and off track just a bit after that one he had earlier.
Green against Terry. Some nice ball movement here by the Heat. Bosch inside, defended by Jones. Down to five on the shot clock. Bosch drives in, and Capella sends it back.
They've been the glass eaters today, guys. A ton of effort out of them down low.
It's been a difference maker for them in this game. That's what's put them in front.
Now here's Terry. 7-point game, the biggest lead in the game.
Oh, they own the interior right now. 10 straight points coming from inside.
Well, constantly finding lanes to the basket, getting great looks inside.
And the Rockets were a tough team last year, but at times, it really felt like a one-man show. Harden carried them so much for so long. You just have to wonder if it wore him out.
Now here's Terry, following the miss by Chris Bosh. Jones kicks to Decker. Shoots it up. That one wide left. Heat shooting under 40% all in all for the game. And it's blocked. And here is Brewer. It's Terry outside, and he gets the bucket. Terry's got 7 points in the game.
I really like the fact that he's getting the touches he needs here after not scoring a single point in that first quarter.
Bosch, the screen. Dragic dishes to Green. Will it go? And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a 3-point play.
He's got unusual height for the shooting guard spot, and it definitely came in handy on that play.
A different look for Miami. Chris Anderson has checked in for Bosch, and Winslow subbed in for Goran Dragic. Houston also making some changes. Harrell, he's checked in for Terrence Jones. McDaniels comes in for Decker, and it's Patrick Beverley in for Jason Terry. Here's McDaniels. And it's in after a nice bounce off the right side. And the Rockets lead by 11. Miami's gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Now here's Green. 8 points for him. Tries again, and it's laid in by Stoudemire. Stoudemire's got four this quarter.
He got a great read of where that miss was going, and that allowed him to be the first guy to it and get the putback.
The clock runs out, and we're heading to halftime. Rockets ahead. They lead by nine. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Thank you, Kevin. Here with Dwayne Wade. And, Dwayne, do you think the defense will be the focus for the second half?
Well, it is. You know, we got to get more stops. And when we get opportunities to get on transition, we got to look up and we got to get the ball up. I think right now we're getting rebounds and we're taking a break. We got to go, man. We got a very deep team we got to use. And so second half, we're going to look to run a little more.
Thank you so much. Back to you guys at the table.
Thank you, Doris, and we'll be back for the third quarter of action following halftime.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hi again, everybody. Ernie Johnson here, joined by Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Welcome to the halftime show on 2K Sports. Houston found themselves in a close game in the first. Their biggest lead during the opening period was 5. They showed their superiority in the second quarter and got well out in front, taking a 9-point lead into the locker room at the half. What'd you think, Shaq, about the first half we saw from the Rockets?
The area where they impressed me the most has been on the boards. When the shot's going up, everybody goes for it. Just a matter of maintaining that energy, playing with that same kind of aggression in the final two quarters.
Kenny, what'd you think about Miami?
Well, they're facing a very hot team in the first half. I mean, guys are shooting the ball lights out. But you have to do more to get stops. I mean, tough defense is the key. And if you put pressure on the ball and more bodying up down low, that's going to establish more aggressive tone that might shut them down in the second half.
And that'll wrap up our halftime show. The third quarter set to go moments from now. We will be right back here after the game.
Second half just about to get going here.
Check out the game for Bosch. He has 8 points and he has one steal to his credit as well.
And Clark, he's just done a great job defensively. That one steal doesn't tell the whole story.
The Heat trail by 9. The big men are Bosch and Whiteside. Wade and Dang are the 2 and 3. And it's Dragic in at the point. That's the group on the 4 for Miami. Wade with it, and it's Harden picking him up. Bosch. That falls. Nice feed that time from Dwayne Wade. Wade's got 3 assists in the game. It's Harden with the drive. Miami grabs the miss. Bosch has got his 3rd rebound on the night. Outside Dragic. Back to Bosch. There's the triple, and he gets it to go. Bosch has got 5 points now in the quarter. And for Goran Dragic, so incredibly efficient on the offensive end over the last couple years, whether with Phoenix or Miami, he's really upped his game.
You know, Kevin, it took him a few years to kind of get comfortable in the NBA, much like the great Steve Nash, who had his struggles early in his career. Now the game is kind of slowed down for him. He's not forcing as much, and it has certainly paid off.
And here is Howard following Chris Bosh's 3. Howard kicks to Harden. The baseline J. And count it. 2 points with a chance for one more at the free throw line.
Yeah, he earned that one. I mean, taking the hit and still able to get that one to go down.
Incredible, incredible body control right there. Don't know how he was able to get that one to go, but it sure was a thing of beauty to watch.
Talking about Dragic's newfound efficiency, he's shot over 50% from the field the past 3 years. I mean, impressive. That's a really high percentage for a point guard who plays so aggressively.
And talking about Goran Dragic, he's learned how to play under control without losing his speed. I mean, early in his career, he committed way too many turnovers. Now he's able to push the action without making so many of those mental mistakes. That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often. Just a great job of attacking on the break.
Yeah, you know, exploding to the basket like that, Greg, just as soon as that ball was going the other way, that's exactly how you want to do it.
Now, here's Wade. Bosch kicks to Dragic. Whiteside a screen. Dragic the pass to Whiteside. Shot clock at 5. Wade drives in. And it's off the back rim. No good.
That's a huge part of what they want to do defensively. Limit his easy chances inside.
The 3 from Harden. and another three for Houston.
They're doing work here in the second half. Three or four to start.
The Heat trail by 11. Dragic dishes to Whiteside. Harden against Wade. Back to Whiteside. Looking for Dang. He gets it there. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Dang's got 9.
The defense has not been able to keep the ball out of the paint at that end of the floor.
And I'd be interested to know.
Whoa! Oh, my goodness. He's just getting nasty on them now. Wow.
Yeah, now that they've built up a lead, this is when he really breaks out those incredibly slick moves.
Man, like a Ginsu knife, just slicing and dicing.
That was a nice replay brought to you by Kia. You think back to the 2009 draft, the Thunder selecting James Harden third overall, and there was some second guessing there.
Yeah, and Tyreke Evans, Kevin, taking a pick after him, won Rookie of the Year, but with time, Harden's talent has proven out, and you could argue he should have gone first in that draft.
A moment to check in with Doris Burke. Doris?
Well, guys, I was able to listen in on what Eric Spoelstra was going over with his team in that last huddle. He made it clear that their offense needed to run through Dang. Coach emphasized getting him as many touches as possible, saying he is going to be one of the guys to carry us the rest of the way. Coach was not wasting any time in altering their strategy here in the second half. And Kevin, he's going to have to hope those changes take effect quickly.
Thanks a lot, Doris.
And you know, you think of Harden on the Thunder. They didn't want to give him that max contract, but it's hard to argue that he's not worth every penny. And guys, when you talk to other players on the Rockets, James Harden more and more becoming a vocal leader. I mean, tremendous confidence and swagger and determination, but that confidence can be contagious, and it's allowing him now to be a leader on this team.
Lawson kicks to Harden. Odiunis against Bosch. Odiunis' shot is good. Odiunis has got 6.
Boy, this defense is getting eaten up on the inside, guys, giving up far too many free runs to the rim.
And they haven't been able to return the favor with their offense in the paint because that has not been up to par.
Here's Dragic, the kick out to Dang. The shot, that's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Dragic has got 9 assists now tonight. Second half here, we're just over 3.5 minutes into it. Lawson against Dragic. Lawson the pass to Harden. Lawson dishes to Odiunis. And some nice passing there by Houston. From 12 feet out, it's hauled in by the Heat. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this game. And that game is the second of 2 straight at home. Dragic kicks to Wade. To the middle. Here's Bosch. And lots of contact there. Missing the shot. He'll shoot 2. That's on Dwight Howard.
And it was a very public falling out between Goran Dragic and the Suns front office. That was a real tense few weeks there before ultimately he was traded.
And a chance for just a second to check out the scoring breakdown for the Rockets.
Well, I got to say, one thing that stuck out all game is the consistent penetration they've gotten.
Yeah, but I also like the balance because they're doing a great job of getting inside and converting around the rim. I really like their aggressiveness.
Here's Jones, and there's the slam dunk to finish it off.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
The Heat trail by 9. And, of course, Dragic was traded to Miami last season, said he felt betrayed by the Suns front office, which spurred him wanting out of Phoenix and to South Florida.
Yeah, you know what? We'll never know the whole truth about that situation, but Dragic said they told him one thing with personnel and did something else.
Watson the pass to Harden. And they're going to count the bucket and send him to the line. It could be a 3-point play.
Some defensive breakdowns are starting to show up now. Their last 4 buckets allowed have come from very close range.
Yeah, high percentage shots are what they are getting in terms of the attempts, and that's just not going to get it done. They've got to figure it out.
This is his third trip to the free throw line.
And I know he was pleased with his foul shooting last year. How about 87% from the line?
And guys, if a game was coming down to the wire and an opponent needed to foul, I mean, he was the guy they wanted with the ball in his hands. I mean, shooting the free throws because of his proficiency there.
Whiteside, a screen on Ariza. Just five to shoot. Rogic kicks to Wade. His three-pointer's off the mark.
The mechanics totally out of whack right now. He's lost his feel for the shot.
Yeah, he really has. I mean, just totally out of sync. I mean, you can just see it in the numbers. Nothing going down for him right now.
Lawson kicks to Ariza. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Rockets will retain possession.
Deckers check in for Houston.
Here is Harden, 18 points for him. Down low, deflects the pass, and so the ball out of bounds. Bosch touched it last.
And really, no choice but to lunge for that pass to make sure it didn't get through.
Yeah, and that was important. Probably would have been a quick 2 points if he doesn't get a hand on it and knock it out of bounds.
Jason Terry has checked in for Houston. And as it goes out of bounds, Houston able to keep the ball here. And it's out of bounds. The Heat will take it the other way.
You always want a player to have his head up and to be surveying the court, but not if that's going to be the result.
So it's Miami now. 9-point game. Rogic dishes the Bosch. Right side a screen. Outside Dang. Bosch heads the pick for Wade. Shot clock at 6. The drive by Bosch. And that one's good. Bosch has got 11 here in this quarter alone.
Great quarter for him at the offensive end, trying to will his team back in the game.
Harden kicks to Howard. He feeds it to Jones. And so the ball out of bounds. Bosch touched it last.
A chance here to check out how the Rockets ranked in the NBA last season. Second in fast break points, third in steals. And they also ranked among the top 5 in points off turnovers, so did a nice job of turning people over and then turning those turnovers into points.
And as you pointed out, when it came to running the break, I mean, they were terrific. They left teams really just grasping for breath and unable to match that breakneck pace.
That'll be a 5-second call.
Looking now at the numbers for Dragic. Good season for him last year. He put in about 16 points a game last year. 4 assists and 3 rebounds. And he's really been pulling his weight. He's had a hand in some big plays here recently.
Yeah, in every way, I think he's doing a much better job, and the numbers certainly support that.
Stoudemire with a screen on Beverly. Rogic the pass to Whiteside. Here's Green. Cannot hit. And Houston the other way now. They've held a 12-point lead earlier.
And they hold a huge advantage on the backboards.
Greg, and that's been the key to this lead. I mean, they've really dominated the glass.
Here's Jones. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
You know, of the last 6 baskets, 5 have come on the interior. This is major smash-mouth basketball, guys.
It's all about imposing your will offensively, getting exactly the kind of looks their coach drew up.
Anderson, he's checked in for Whiteside. And a change for the Rockets. McDaniels checked in. That one's in there. Rocket lead is cut down now to just 7 on the basket from Green. Houston's gone 1-2 from beyond the arc since coming out of the break. Beverly with the ball. He hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Jones against Anderson. And the basket by Jones. And the Rockets lead by 9.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Well, Greg, after a run of 10 playoff trips in 11 years, the Miami Heat missing the postseason last year, they'd end up a game back of the eighth spot.
Yeah, and what's hard for the Heat, Kevin, is that they were in the playoff picture for most of the year, and as the season wore on, they slowly fell out of that top eight.
Here's McDaniels, guarded by Green. It's stolen by Green. Outside Dragic, the pass to Stoudemire. Green, left side. Over to the wing, six to shoot. Green, missing again. Rockets leading by seven. Dishes it to McDaniels. He kicks it to Jones. Pass to Capella. Feeds it to McDaniels. A runner. And he can't bank that one in. Dragic left side. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
No question about it, Greg. I mean, a ton of contact and a good call by the officials.
It's his first trip to the line.
77% shooter at the line a season ago. Those are better than average numbers.
So for the Rockets, Harrell comes in for Jones. And Corey Brewer's subbed in for Decker.
They're locked in from the charity stripe this half. Not a miss yet.
And trying to cut into this lead, they need every edge they can get.
Here's Capella, banked in off the glass. Capella's got six.
Good look. He'll make that one most of the time.
Outside, Green. There's the dish to Anderson. Passes it to Dragic. Back to Anderson. That's in, coming off an assist from Dragic. Anderson's got his first 2 points. Rockets leading by five. Beverly dishes to McDaniels. Harrell with it.
Oh! Ooh, that's as forceful a finish as you're ever going to see out of this guy.
Well, gee, it adds now to their lead in spectacular fashion.
And, you know, that lead's only going to grow if they're not prepared to defend a little more staunchly than that.
Dragic kicks to Stoudemire. They set the pick. The drive by Green. Count the bucket. Green's got 12 in the game.
They're not as aggressive from the outside here, but maybe they should think about stretching the defense a little bit, like they did in the first half. I mean, stretching the defense makes it easier to score inside, too.
Harrell kicks to Capella. Anderson with the block. 1:10 left in the third quarter. Winslow wide open. He fires off target with the open look. Houston in the lead. Here's McDaniels. Harrell the pass to Beverly. No good with the triple. Miami's gone 2 of 3 when they ventured outside the arc in the third quarter. Dragic dishes to Stoudemire. There's a good screen. Back to Dragic. Outside, Green. The three. And the rebound goes to the Rockets. They've held a 12-point lead earlier. 7-second difference, shot and game clock. And Brewer kicks to McDaniels. Goes up the baseline. No good. Great D that time from Green. Outside Dragic. He dishes it to Winslow. Miami no good on that time either. And we've reached the end of the third. Rockets lead by five. Back after this from the American Airlines Arena. We welcome you back to what has been a good one here as we get into the fourth quarter. Rockets leading by five. Fourth quarter on the court for the Rockets. Cody Unis and Howard, the post pair. Corey Brewer is out there with Lawson. And it's Ariza in at the three spot. And it's good. Fought through contact, hits the shot. He'll go to the free throw line. That sends Trevor Ariza to the free throw line. They get Luol Deng. The Rockets making a switch here. Harden's checked in. Well, guys, before last season, Trevor Ariza signing a four-year, $32 million deal with the Rockets. Big free agent get for the team.
And, you know, they wanted to re-sign Chandler Parsons, Kevin, but with his departure, in comes Ariza, and Trevor is a quality replacement. I mean, a terrific wing defender. And he's a nice spot-up shooter as well.
And they'll be counting on even more points from him. That's essential if they're going to pull this game out.
Lawson kicks to Howard. It's hauled in by the Heat. Bosch has got his fourth rebound in this one.
And, you know, you compare their games. Ariza a bit more limited maybe offensively than Parsons, a few years older, but he's also a better defender and also better at playing without the basketball. Remember, you got five guys out there, only one ball. Sometimes your chemistry can improve when a guy doesn't need the basketball to be effective.
Howard with the steal. And here comes Harden, leading the fast break. The rim-rattling two-handed jam.
Dwight Howard with some slick passing on that one.
The Heat trail by nine.
And, you know, for the Rockets, a nice pairing with James Harden and Trevor Ariza. Ariza, a spot-up shooter and defender, while Harden arguably the premier offensive creator in the league. I mean, they really complement each other well.
And that's how you make a steal count. Turn it into a quick slam at the other end.
It was really a case. It looked like Greg Anthony right there, if I can say so. It was really a case of a great defensive play triggering some instant offense.
Yeah, I remember GA as an irritant, and this guy, much like Greg, creating havoc out there.
Stay on the clock from deep. Green. Miami no good on that time either.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Yeah, rebounding has been a big key in this one, Greg. They've asserted their will and have taken control on the glass.
Here's Howard, and that one is stuffed right through.
Boy, he's just dangling from the rim after sending it through there.
You can see which team now has the swagger, Clark, right now.
Yeah, it's with them.
And guys, that swagger can backfire because you don't want to get your opponent a little too riled up.
Bosch, that's the pick for Wade. Back to Bosch. Deng passes to Green. Fades back, and he gets the bucket.
I like the recognition of the mismatch there, immediately making the defense pay.
They've been very untidy with the ball here. You commit turnovers when you try to do too much or you force it. They need to focus on making the simple play, good passes, and moving the ball around.
Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Thanks, guys. I was able to hear Kevin McHale coaching his team during that break. He wants to make sure they stay assertive and aggressive on the offensive end, saying, I don't want to sit on this lead. Let's build on it and not give them a chance of coming back. Guys?
Harden, no good.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Deng for three. Rockets with the rebound. Now Harden. Lawson outside. Harden with it. He's picked up by Deng. Harden dishes to Howard. Goes to the fadeaway and cans it. Howard's got the lead up to 13 now for the Rockets. For Miami, they've gone 2 for 5 on field goal attempts in the fourth quarter. Timeout called, the Heat. Well, looking back on last season, you didn't know where the Rockets would end up in terms of seeding in the playoffs. Ended up with the 2 seed because they won the Southwest Division. And as it turned out, everything worked out very well for them.
It really did. And had a divisional matchup in that first round against the Mavs. But the Rockets took care of business in that series and would advance.
No one near Whiteside as he lets it go. Again, the miss by the Heat. Ariza kicks to Harden. And a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Yeah, I mean, I'm all for good offense, but that was just a terrible reaction from the defense. And, you know, for the Rockets, they had a major gut check in the second round. Went down 3-1 against the Clippers. Came back to win the series in 7, including game 6, when I dozed off when they were trailing by 19 in the fourth and was shocked to wake up in the morning and see they had forced the 7th game.
Rockets leading by 13. Howard. Lawson kicks to Ariza. Back to Lawson. Harden. Whiteside against Howard. And stolen by Whiteside. Outside, Green. Pass to Wade. Fader on the way. Wade missing again.
And with the Rockets' last postseason, their trip to the conference finals was as far as they would go. Went out to the Warriors in 5 games. Most of them, though, close ones. I think most fans were pleased with how far the team went last year in spite of all the injuries.
Harden against Wade. Pulls from the top of the key. That one off the back iron and out.
Well, I think he had all the space he needed. He just couldn't find the bottom of the net.
Green with the ball. Now Lawson defending. Lawson against Green. Whiteside a screen on Lawson. And there's the call on Bosch. That's his 3rd foul of the game. Goran Dragic is checked in for Miami. Rockets leading by 13. Lawson kicks to Ariza. To the paint. That's good from Howard on the assist by Ariza. Ariza's got his 4th assist in this one.
It seems that every pass they make is leading to a score here. I mean, that's just exquisite ball movement.
And that's because the ball is looking for the best shot, and it's really paid off for them during the run.
The 11-footer, and the jumper falls for him. 24 points for Chris Bosh.
He's been a different guy here in the second half. His shooting percentage far better than it was before the break.
Miami's gotten just 1 of 4 three-pointers to go down for them here in the 4th. Dragic against Ariza. It's Dragic with the drive. Great D that time from Howard.
And that's the way you want to defend. Nice job.
Always important to have that good interior defense. Maybe could have tried for a more memorable dunk than that.
And we know he's capable of those memorable dunks.
Yeah, and when he's got a lead like that, why not take a few chances? A lot more engaging and entertaining than just doing the old ho-hum one-hander.
And something not a lot of people talk about, Ty Lawson's defense. He has the lateral quickness, Clark, and strong lower body that gives, you know, point guards fits.
Yeah, he's like a fire hydrant in terms of his build and strength. He's a good ball defender, but he gambles sometimes, so that can cut both ways. He'll get steals, but he'll also put you in tough positions defensively.
Harden, that's good. Harden's got 18 points just in the second half.
And he could be the guy to put this game out of reach.
And it's out of bounds to the Heat as Miami retains possession. Howard with the steal. Harden outside. And Howard with the stuff. And that's a double-double for him now. 10 points and 10 rebounds.
And you can see the difference with their ability to win with their speed, guys.
Boy, I love the pace and flow that their open-court offense has been played with. I mean, it's been
coming quietly, but very efficiently.
Harden kicks to Howard. To the wing right side. Houston moving it around. And Lawson, here we go. And stolen by Whiteside. And here is Dang. The feed to Wade. Fires for three. Rebounded by Howard. Howard's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Lawson kicks to Ariza. Back to Lawson. Ariza outside to the inside. And two free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And guys, Dwight Howard's an interesting guy. One of the most physically imposing players in our league. And yet he's known for his lighthearted, almost playful nature.
And for Howard, his parents raised him to keep a smile on his face and stay upbeat and remain positive. He's done all those things and still competed in the rough and tumble world of pro basketball.
Yeah, and yet some of his peers and contemporaries have gone at him. Durant, for instance, Kobe Bryant called himself, Byron Scott questioned his desire. Guys go about their work in different manners.
A lot's been made of the Heat fans in the past for walking out during the finals game where they looked to be out of it, but credit, you know, the Miami Heat fans, Greg, with last year sticking with this team.
Yeah, and in all fairness, I would have walked out as well because I thought it was over. But with LeBron out of town, a lot of Heat fans could have jumped off the bandwagon. But you know what? They stayed with it. So although the weather is fair, the fans are not.
Oh, well said.
Thank you.
And, you know, for the Heat, despite the struggles, they still sold out every game here last season. They were among the top teams in the league in total attendance.
And really, they showed up in force. Even as the Heat fell to the back of the pack, the Heat only 20-21 last year at American Airlines Arena, but the fans love them all the same.
It's Ariza on the wing. Now, here is Harden. The three. And it's Whiteside with the rebound.
And he made sure not to just draw the foul. That was good defense out on the perimeter.
Very good. He's a thinking man's defender. Knows how to bother even the best shooters without being overly aggressive. Timeout call.
And the Heat call time here.
Boy, last season, Hassan Whiteside made a huge splash in the NBA. Big blocks, big rebound totals. But he had some head-scratching moments as well. Missed his share of action due to suspensions.
There's a screen. Wade for three. And it's Wade again missing.
No other way to put it. Just a rough quarter in terms of scoring. He has not been helping at all.
And, G.A., as you said, with Whiteside, his fiery attitude flared up a few times last season, and it hurt his team more than once in Miami.
No doubt, and it's something that he has got to work on. I mean, he's proven that he can be a big-time player in this league, but he can't have the mental lapses that get him tossed from games and hurt his team.
Whiteside sets the pick for Wade. Kicks to Dragic. Bosh, a screen on Ariza. Doubled by Howard. Five to shoot. Whiteside. And that's good. And it's Dragic with the assist.
Even double team. He had the vision to see the open man.
It's Harden with the drive. That's good. Harden's got 11 here in this quarter alone.
He's finding all kinds of ways to get it done. What a quarter he's having.
Bosh sets the pick for Dragic. Outside Bosh. Lets it go with a three. Mateunas grabs the miss. Mateunas has got his seventh rebound here tonight. That is good. And that's 15 points for Trevor Ariza.
Another bucket down low. They've been the aggressors, taking the ball inside and attacking at the rim.
You're exactly right. It's been all good at one end, and let's be diplomatic and just say not so good at the other end.
He muscles it in through the contact, and they call the foul. He's on his way to the free throw line.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for the Rockets.
But, Steve, you know, you don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out, Clark, this kind of punishment to.
Well, you know what? I thought they did a nice job of playing against the game. They kept the pressure on and clearly were dominant in every area.
And every win important. And this one will go down as win number three.
Sometimes, guys, it's hard during the first meeting of a season to get a feel for a team, but these guys came out and made the necessary adjustments, and I think they've got to feel good about going up 1-0 in the season series against the Heat.
No surprise here, just a big-time performance for Harden. There wasn't much they could do to slow him down as he was converting every good chance he got.
Here's Harrell. Drops it in from 14 feet away.
And this is going to be a fantastic result for them. No win on the road comes easy.
Not in the NBA, they don't. And trust me, they're going to take a little extra pleasure in this win, having silenced an entire building of hostile fans.
First free throw is good. He hits one and misses one, each at the line. Here's Houston now. McDaniels kicks to Jones. Right side, Terry. And he banks in the layup.
Terrific run to seal the deal.
Yeah, and now let's just keep an eye on how much longer they keep the foot on the accelerator.
So we see the Rockets taking the win here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't care what the matchup is. You never expect a road team to come in and just cruise to the kind of win they did tonight.
And a chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Dwight, the team seemed to surge in the second half with a renewed life. What did you tell the guys during halftime?
Just told our guys we got to finish the game, you know. They're a good team, and we don't want to let them get close. So we did a good job of playing our game tonight, you know, and not rushing. And just, we got a good win.
Dwight, congratulations. Kevin, back to you.
All right, Doris, great job. Thanks so much. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And we send you now over to Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Welcome back, Ernie Johnson, along with Shaq and Kenny the Jet. Let's quickly move forward now to the presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, James Harden. He had an outstanding third quarter. Whatever they needed in terms of energy and offense, he was the firepower that propelled them during the second half.
Anytime you deliver that sort of production we saw from him tonight, you're going to put your team in position to win. He gave them points in bunches, and when they needed them. It's not always about how much you get, but when you get those points up on the board.
There was nothing they could do to slow him down, Ernie. Man, going to a building on the road and completely control the action like he did, only a few players could do that, Ernie. I'm impressed.
And that brings us to the end of our broadcast for this evening. For Kenny Smith, Shaquille O'Neal, Kevin Harlan, and our illustrious 2K Sports crew, this is Ernie Johnson saying good night, and we'll see you again soon, but not soon enough.